Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we are going to talk about steps in gradients, such as this look in here. So you have a gradient, but the color change is visible in steps. Now, in this video, I'm using Illustrator 2022 because I'm using plugins that are not installed in the higher version. Let's first start with this as actually an issue. When you have a gradient that is too long and the change of color is too subtle, then you get a phenomenon that is called banding. Let's take a look at it. I'm opening the gradient panel, and then let's change this stop to something like in here. And you can already see the steps. So this is called banding, and it often appears in forums when people are asking what causes it. So it's caused when the gradient is too long and the difference between those two colors is not enough. This is something that you need to solve with production. You need to solve this with the printer and ask them if their technology can solve this. Let's take a look at how you can get this effect on purpose. The first method to do that is, let's have this in one color and make a copy of it, and then set this to a different color. And these can be any shapes. So you can do that with freeform shapes. And then you go to Object, Blend, Mix. Now in here, you again see an impression of a gradient that doesn't show any steps. But we can change that by double-clicking the Blend tool and then just go in here and input a lower number. And now we've got visible steps. That's the first method. Then we also have a method that is based on an existing gradient. So let's just apply a gradient to this, and then we can also convert that. So we can go to Expand, and then expand the fill and specify the number of objects. Let's take 20 again. And then this gradient gets expanded to a number of objects. Now these are grouped. And let's ungroup it and see what Illustrator has created. Again, there's a clip group. So let's release that as well. And then we have these objects, and Illustrator has created this kind of object sequence. Again, this can be also made from other objects, so we can have a different shape. It can be any shape. I'm going to use a circle here. And let's again apply that gradient, and this time make it a radial gradient, and also this can be expanded, specify 20 objects, and then you have this as circles that are stacked into each other. So that is the next method. Also, you can create that in the gradient. So we have this shape here. It has the gradient already applied because that's what I've used previously, and then we can edit it in the gradient so that the result will be a live gradient. And you do that by duplicating the gradient stop. And then what you need to do is move those two on top of each other. And when you use just Illustrator's tools, then what you can do is input, let's say 30% for this one, and then you select this one and input 30% as well. And then you get a hard step here. So this is a sharp step. And you can do the same with the other ones. So again, make a copy here. And this is the wrong one that I have duplicated there. So we need to take this one and have it duplicated. And now we need to edit this again. So let's set this here, and that one should be 55%. And this one as well. And this time I'm going to make a copy before that. So let's set this to 55. And you see where this goes. So it can be edited. But this kind of editing can also be made simpler by using the plugin that I was hinting at in the beginning. So we're going to Window, Astute Graphics, and then Gradient Forge. And you see already what Illustrator has done here when I have set them to the same position, and this plugin can kind of automate that. So let's make a copy here and another copy here. And let's select both of them, and then you can go into the menu and stack them. And select these two and stack them as well. And then we have these steps in the gradient, and it's much easier. Also, with this plugin, let's make a copy of that over here, just like this. They are magnetic. So let's make another copy, and you see they snap. And this is much easier to do than with Illustrator's gradient panel, just like this. So this is how you can have steps in your gradient.